Boundless Spirit, pushing the limits of talk radio with Charlene Springer.
Hi, I'm Dr. Len Horowitz, and I'm on with Charlene Springer. This is Boundless Spirit Radio.
Welcome to Boundless Spirit Radio with Charlene Springer. Wow, we have a wonderful show for you today. We've got Dr. Leonard G. Horowitz on with us. And he is an internationally known authority in the overlapping fields of public health, behavioral science, emergent diseases, and natural healing. He began his career as an anatomy instructor on the faculty of Tufts and Harvard Universities. Dr. Horowitz is a retired dentist, periodontal surgeon, behavioral scientist. He is also an award-winning filmmaker and the author of over 16 books on medicine versus natural healing. Welcome, Dr. Horowitz. How are you today?
Very good, Charlene. Thank you for inviting me.
Great. Is it okay if we call you Len today?
Sure, that's fine.
Great. Okay, Len. I didn't know where to start with you. There were just so many things that you do. I can go all over the place. The first thing I'd like to touch, though, is you did a lot of research, and some of your books are about different viruses and diseases that have shown up on our planet, things that weren't here before. We're looking at Zika, we're looking at Ebola, and you did this whole thing on AIDS when AIDS was, you know, running rampant. Do you want to talk a little bit about that, how these biologically engineered diseases show up, basically?
Sure, be happy to. First of all, the rampant spread of HIV/AIDS is still happening. It's not going away. There's somewhere in the neighborhood of 30 million people that have died thus far, 25 to 35, 30 some odd million. And what's happened, the only difference currently is that the mainstream media and the drug cartel doesn't want to publicize the fact that it's still spreading horribly, and that the reason for that is that there seems to be, because of my work largely, there is a suppression of information, and there has never been a scientific response. So you have a virtual, what's called tacit admission in law. In law, when someone, let's say a plaintiff or somebody like myself, says a claim mm-hmm. that AIDS was man-made, it was created in a laboratory, and it was loosed for profitable depopulation, if some scientist comes out and actually publishes documentation and evidence to that claim, then it's really appropriate. It's actually a duty of the scientific community to prevent the problem of what's called genocide, AIDS genocide. If there's a fairly reasonable amount of evidence, and in our case, we've got not simply clear and convincing evidence, we have what's called prima facie evidence. It's like in your face. Mm-hmm. It is the contracts. I literally published the United States government contracts under which numerous AIDS-like and Ebola-like viruses were bioengineered by the Army's sixth top biological weapons contracting lab called Litton Bionetics. They were a medical subsidiary of the mega military weapons contracting firm called Litton Industries, and they ran the entire National Cancer Institute. They paid all the researchers for the NCI. They administered the programs for the NCI. And they held the contract to distribute all the monkey cell lines, chimpanzees, everything mm-hmm. having to do with cancer virus research, including hepatitis B vaccine research. The whole concept was the contract was tied into a Merck pharmaceutical company contract. to develop cancer vaccines. And so hepatitis was a premier, one of the earliest major focuses. And so that's where what I did was extraordinary. In the book Emerging Viruses, AIDS and Ebola, Nature, Accident, or Intentional, it asks the question to the reader. When you get done a 500-page book, it really lets you sit on the question, was what has happened with AIDS, was it an event of nature? Was it caused by an accident, a release into the hepatitis B vaccines and the blood supply of the American Red Cross? Or, given the evidence, was it intentional? So that's essentially the book, and it goes into the science. And so if you then have what's happened, you have the scientific community not respond to the critical question: is this contract, it was NIH, National Institutes of Health, 71-2025, 1971, number 2025. That was the contract. And it was involving the creation of AIDS-like viruses. And if you study the scientific literature, it was done in chimpanzees. And the closest thing going to the HIV, like the cause of AIDS, or at least the virus that's associated with AIDS, because there's a lot of question as to how many people are dying from the drugs.
Huh.
But the association, the association of the fact that the simian immunodeficiency virus from the chimp is about 63% identical to human HIV. And so the scientific community knows that that's the link, and they then divert and obscure, and they don't answer to the claim that I make having republished the United States government contract. Now, in law, that's called a tacit admission.
Mm-hmm.
It's considered a fact before the court. Here we have the court of public opinion and the court of the scientific opinion, and tacitly admits that what I'm saying is true. So that's really why HIV/AIDS has gone from headline news into obscurity. Because, again, I've loosed the intelligence, and it's all about intelligence. As you read my books and even watch my films, it's all about central intelligence or British intelligence, the Anglo-American intelligence industry, diverting, obscuring, censoring, or discrediting people's truth or reality. And so that's what I do.
Wow. Well, this is the way to do it, but then what actually happens, unless you're out there and people are out there talking to you, the average person doesn't know any of this. The average person is still thinking that, oh, wow, AIDS must have gone away because no one talks about it anymore.
Yeah, that's right. And that's what they've done a terrific job. You have Google, YouTube censored 157 of my videos. Wikipedia, a few weeks before the Ebola crisis in 2014, they pulled down my entire Wikipedia page. And they had been using Wikipedia, which is a mouthpiece for CIA, Central Intelligence Agency. They're intimately connected, as is Google, YouTube. The whole organization is meant for social control and disinformation. But from 2008 to 2014, they used Wikipedia to discredit me. You know, say all sorts of things. Oh, he's just a dentist. You know, they don't realize that it was a dentist that created the entire field of anesthesiology. There are many, many dentists that have contributed tremendously to public health and medicine. Or they'll, you know, they smear me in other ways. I mean, I've had a group that essentially was a guy named, one was Alma Siat, Dr. Truot, but Ted Gunderson was the big name. A guy named Ted Gunderson, who was the FBI's Division 5 chief in Los Angeles that was targeting the Black Panthers and the Black organizations that were coming up for opposition to the government and for community organization and outrage over the fact that CIA was distributing drugs to the Black community and targeting people like Martin Luther King or Malcolm X. Well, the guy that was assigned to direct that actually targeted me with a whole cell, a whole group of people. And that's expected, you know, after all these years, and I've been at this now for about a quarter century, and I work with a fantastic investigative journalist named Sherry Kane. Mm. And before Kane came on board in 2009, I mean, I thought these people were nice people. I had no idea. I had no idea that they were stabbing me in the back, that they were trying, publishing all of this discrediting information to oppose me. They set up websites. They created a sex tape. They did all the standard things that they did to Martin Luther King or Malcolm X before they got to him. You know, gee whiz, that's what their agenda is. And if you start to research who they are and then find out and then what they are actually doing, they're actually following a protocol. And because I have the background in Harvard, from Harvard trained behavioral science media persuasion expert, that's my basic training. So I got a hold of their training manuals. I got a hold of them when Edward Snowden and leaked the intelligence from here, a company in Hawaii, Hamilton, Booze Hamilton is where he was working for Central Intelligence and National Security Agency, and he got a hold of their files and he downloaded them. You know the story of Edward Snowden.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so when Glenn Greenwald, who was publicizing Snowden's stolen information, he published the training manuals that a behavioral science team put together to train the agents that discredit people like you and me. And so having the intelligence and the knowledge of understanding what this was that I was looking at, then going through it as a scientist would, as a behavioral scientist would, gee whiz, I know exactly how they operate. I know exactly what they do. I know exactly what's happening right now in the president's, you know, White House. How come they're responding? Who's responding to the president of the United States right now the way they're responding and what the other side is doing?
Mm.
You know, and I see it and I'm watching it unfold, and it's very true what you said, because the vast majority of people don't have that intelligence. They don't have that knowledge. That means they're susceptible to being manipulated and killed. And that's what's happening. There is an agenda to do that. People make money from doing that. And they're clueless about the divisiveness, because dividing people, dividing male from female,
mm-hmm.
you know, men from women, Black from white, Jew from Gentile, Christian from Muslim, Democrat mm-hmm. from Republican, rich from poor. It's a division game. And on your show, which you're dedicated to spirituality and a correct, lawful, righteous connection to mm-hmm. the creator of the universe, which is one. You know, all of the religions have essentially spun off of Hebrew, you know, Judaism.
Right.
You know, and that's monotheism. That's the essence of monotheism. And the essence of that is that we're all lovingly connected, joyfully uplifted, miraculously healed and sustained by a creator or nature, and nature's is a creation of sustenance and balance. And that's the reality. Now, how did we get from there into the corruption in the judicial system and in degenerating humanity's perspective on everything from each other? You know, we can't have, you know, how many marriages fail today? Relationships are horrible. The children today are living virtual realities on their video screen and television. This is not real. I mean, in fact, the video screen's most dangerous, in my opinion, most dangerous currently is the fact that you watch television and it's so much more colorful and real than reality.
I actually noticed that. I do photos, sunrise photos, and you take a photo and, you know, it looks good. And if you, no one says anything, but you add a little Photoshop, brighten it up a little bit, and people go crazy.
That's
and
right.
You know, you get to see, you're like, wow, this is really what it is, that people don't, or they're not interested in what's real.
That's exactly right. And see, it's one thing to do that for art, mm-hmm. or just do it for, you know, the fun of it, or serendipity, have it happen. Mm-hmm. But it's another thing to realize that that's a technology that could be used very effectively for social control.
Yeah.
And that takes you literally another step out of reality. Like I just mentioned a couple minutes ago, you have central intelligence agents that operate via these kinds of very sophisticated diversion, you know, corruption of intelligence, disinformation, discrediting good true sources, and then diverting or discrediting. And then you have that level of social control. And then you have subliminal messaging, which this is partly a very powerful subliminal message, because if they, in a cult-ure, in our cult-ure, in which the young people are now being engineered to see reality as not quite colorful, not quite good enough, not spectacular, not exciting, not emotionally challenging or thrilling enough, then they go into that boob tube, and that's where their reality is. And so it's really a social control mechanism that is treasonous in law, because you have a country, a nation that is founded on the magnificent Constitution and the Judeo-Christian ethics, and it's ethics that is at the heart of philosophy, of all religions, of all Buddhism to Judaism. It's all about how do we act civilly towards one another?
Mm.
What is the ethics of love? What is the ethics of joy and freedom, sovereignty, and this capacity that we have as human beings to be productive and supportive with each other and for each other? And social service is at the heart of what the meaning of life is. And it's well proven. You know, when you have two spouses, they live to, let's say, 90 years old. One spouse dies. The other one says, I'm not going to stay around anymore. My loved one's gone. And the spouse dies, too, very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
It's about caring for each other as loving human beings. You see this when you have a group of ants. You know, a lot of people have killed a lot of ants. Mm-hmm. You know, and you leave a couple dead bodies of ants around, and all of a sudden the other ants come and pick up the bodies and walk away with them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know, so it's kind of like that's part of the law. The law is that we're together. The law is that we're one. The law is that we're caring for each other and supportive of each other and concerned about creating an environment that supports one another. And that is the danger and the damage that's been done by criminal psychopaths.
Wow. Someone actually said that we have had so many psychopaths that have been leaders, presidents, etc. They're like, this is what we always choose, the psychopath.
Yeah, well, the choices in politics are not given to us, as you have seen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and everybody knows that, you know, and that is a common understanding. But what is bizarre, as a behavioral science expert, is the fact that we do it over and over and over again.
We didn't learn the lesson the first time. That means that the psychological warfare is really working well.
Yeah, exactly. Now, you know, my orientation on Donald Trump, and I share this with Sherry Kane, journalist Sherry Kane, is that assuming, let's give him the benefit of the doubt, assuming that he wasn't put up to play this role, then at this point, he's probably thinking to himself, what the hell did he get himself into?
He had that look on his face first time.
Yeah.
Oh, man. This has been total field day for people who see past, you know, antics. And then they just look at the whole situation. You go, oh, my God, this is so crazy. Yep.
Yeah. Now, the fact of the matter is you've got to see the craziness as a symptom of design.
Mm-hmm.
The craziness is part of what's called the managed chaos. It's controlled. It's actually crisis capitalism, and it is controlled, engineered, and it is within that chaos that you have military and police state and the imbalance in society and the degeneration of the civility, ethics, morals, values. We all don't want to go to war, but yet we're now constantly going to war. You know, so it's crazy, man. It's just a symptom of how insane our leaders are and the bankers are that wield Wall Street and the corporations. These are criminal psychopaths, and they don't vibe to love. They don't vibe to anything but arrogance and greed, and they are faithful. They don't have a connection to the creator. There's a psychological operation, brand new movie that Rupert Murdoch and 20th Century Fox just came out with a couple weeks ago. And I don't recommend seeing the film because it is a psychological operation. It's a deceptive psychological operation. It's called Cure for Wellness, a cure for wellness.
Rupert Murdoch, really?
Yeah, that's right. Exactly right. In other words, the Murdoch family, who's heavily engaged in AstraZeneca and Merck Pharmaceutical Company, and the son of Murdoch, who wiretapped the British parliamentary and officials in order to extort them and have the news. He's with SmithKline Beecham. So you've got major drug companies invested by Murdoch, which is the mega media. I mean, that's Fox News. That's Wall Street Journal. So 20th Century Fox just came out with this film, A Cure for Your Wellness, and I don't recommend seeing it. It's kind of a stupid movie, but unless you're a behavioral science expert like I am and then can go see and read and really understand what it's about. But why I raise it right now, because it is about the criminal psychopathology of the world's leaders. It is about how soulless and stuck they are. And that aspect of, in other words, the film partly is in self-therapy. They're lost. The criminal psychopaths, because of people like myself, and we've been really smearing their noses in their own shit. And we've been doing it long enough, and because of the internet, there's enough of us, people like yourself, who's out there spreading good truth and wonderful news about how we could take control of wellness and healing and sustain it. So they're confronted with reality, and they have to think in their boardrooms, and they have to get together and figure out, okay, we're globalists, we're what's called the Illuminati, and we're going to have to figure out, now we have a popular uprising, such as people like Donald Trump or his group, purportedly, again, I say purportedly because you're never really sure about what side his supporters are on, for sure. And that they're looking at themselves in a mirror more and more, and they're realizing how meaningless their lives are. the concept of the Illuminati getting to this stage in history and having virtually succeeded. They stand on the threshold of, as Bill Gates says, we've got a problem, folks. There's too many useless eaters on the planet. We've got to kill 6 out of 7 of you. That's what Bill Gates is actually coming right out and telling you in his lectures.
Uh-huh.
In fact, the doomsday clock the other day, a couple weeks ago, they reset the doomsday clock closer to midnight. And a couple of days later, Bill Gates from Germany, how ironic, comes out and says, our greatest threat is bioterrorism now. It's not just nuclear. Civilization could be destroyed unless we distribute more vaccines.
What?
Oh, it's a con job. Yeah, complete. I mean, the guy is a complete demonic, soulless creature, but because he's poisoning people and he's flipping it, saying that people like myself who declare the truth are killing babies because parents are not getting vaccinated. He's talking about a couple. He's fabricating that information, and then he's concealing the millions and millions. It's not just AIDS that we're talking about, having killed over 30 million people globally from a vaccine. You know, my mother died from a 1976 swine flu vaccine that gave her Guillain-Barré, along with tens of thousands of other people that eventually died because of Guillain-Barré. That's the most common vaccine injury, along with eczema. And the whole concept beyond autism, you've got 15% of the population have eczema, which is a skin disorder that's literally caused by the infusion of foreign proteins by the vaccines directly into the bloodstream that causes your immune cells to go haywire and it starts attacking your own body. That's standard of vaccine damage. So hay fever, allergies, where did they come from? They didn't come from just environmental pollution. You have to have those antigens injected into the bloodstream in order to cause people to start sneezing in springtime. You know, so this is, you know, and then you've got vaccines produced in fetal serum, bovine fetal serum.
Yeah.
So the cows are eating grass, and then now you take their blood and you grow viruses in them and you extract all of that, and then now you make a vaccine with it. Now you're going to create other forms of pollution other than just breathing grass antigens. You're going to now be injecting them. So that's just one of about almost 90 new diseases caused from vaccines. So, you know, all of the autoimmune diseases, like I mentioned, Guillain-Barré, Stephen Johnson syndrome, Bell's palsy, a whole variety of others are some of them, they used to be completely rare or completely unknown, but everything today from hay fever, allergies, asthma, the rheumatoid crippling arthritis, the type 1 autoimmune diabetes, these are vaccine injuries. So Gates, what he's out there doing and what the Illuminati are doing are saying, okay, well, people are waking up, and we've had families controlling the money, and our psychopathology has been controlling the mindset and the direction of globalization now for one world government, one world peacekeeping force, NATO, one world bank, One World Health Organization, and we've been evolving this now through the United Nations and other ways, manipulating the currencies, manipulating understanding, intelligence of people. And now we've got the end game here. We've got globalization, one world order. And so now they have to look at themselves in the mirror, and they have to say, okay, was it worth it? And they look at the environment, devastated by design. I mean, literally, the reason why our environment is degraded is not just because you had them suppress Tesla technology and the free energy and continuing to pollute with the petrochemicals that Bill Gates says is the problem, and now instead of solving the problem, instead of going to the free energy, instead of honoring people like Tesla and the energy devices, because energy, the entire universe operates in energy, and it's free. It's all over the place. You can capture that. Tesla showed us how to do that, but the energy industrialists have suppressed it. So he has to look at the fact that he has, with his group, caused the degradation of the environment. And he has to look at himself in a mirror. And when he looks at himself in the mirror, he's got to justify and rationalize what he's done and what he's doing. He sees himself in denial. He sees himself shallow. He sees himself responsible for the deaths of millions, potentially billions of people. Now imagine living in that. And so the film, A Cure for Wellness, actually comes out, and a part of the film deals with that. It's intertwined with a psyops to make you distrust water, literally. It's a mind-bending film that makes you distrust herbalists and natural medicine people. And then on the other side has you reflect on these criminal psychopathology. And that's what the film is about. But it is very, very true. And unfortunately, because people don't have the wherewithal, they don't have all the intelligence to be able. So at any rate, that's what I think is interesting about current events.
Well, I think this is why it's so funny. I don't know if you've heard, I'm sure you've heard of Shari Edwards, who's done bioacoustic sound. And one of the things that she did is she had, I think she was had available unwaxed from you, and you know, stressed how important that was. And there are many other people that just stressed how important it was that we all saw this movie and the information that you shared. So I mean, you've been on people's tongues for quite some while, the people that are out there that are interested in knowing what's been going on this planet. Because you almost look at it and go, okay, well, if this is going on, then who's really behind it? Is this Illuminati, as you would say, you know, the people like the Bill Gates, et cetera, that I guess you'd call it the 5%? Or is it somebody else from off planet? You know, who's really pushing this wheel so that humanity sits in this we have this patterning from the time kids come out with the vaccinations, this education system, how everything works. It follows that choo-choo train that it's almost like putting us in line, all in line to be slaves, and then controlling and manipulating. And, you know, it's like, this is what you watch. You have to wear this on your neck so we know, you know, what you're looking at. We can monitor you from anywhere in space because you'll have your cell phone on with, you know, all that information. You'll have your computer on with the information. So we know everything that's going on about you. And, you know, who's behind all this? Because it feels like it's a lot more than the people that are here on planet.
Yeah, it's the same people pretty much who created the Roman Catholic Church. You mentioned off air, you know, that you're recovering
Catholic,
you know, and, you know, I think I would have to say I'm a recovering Jew. And I think Christians would have to, true Christians, if you're really born again,
right,
you have to say that you're recovering, because, you know, I look at the hypocrisy in the church generally. I see good Christians supposedly running to their medicine cabinets and running to their doctors to handle every sniffle and a cold and whatever symptom they've got. You know, where's your faith and trust? You know, where's your faith? You know, it's like ridiculous. It's bizarre, the level of ignorance and the incredible capability that we have to engage in doctrines and dogmas from religions, when Jesus himself said, beware of those, not just to call themselves Jews, but who are not, but the doctrines and the dogmas, the traditions of men make the word, the truth, the spiritual connectionness, the righteousness to no avail. We can't see it. We know God. you know, my colleague used to say, know ye of God, yet God ye not know. You know, everybody knows about God, but right. What about that intimate connection, that whole spiritual blessing and celebration in heart and soul and spirit of having that oneness and having your whole life be a divine synchronicity and having everything moment to moment, just whatever wherever you are, knowing you're protected by angels of protection, and everywhere you go, you know that it's supposed to be where you're supposed to be. And, you know, that whole level of Christianity or Judeo-Christianity is gone. It's, you know, people are faithless. So I think really being born again, to me, as a Judeo-Christian, because I love Yeshua, and I try to study what Jesus preached. Right. And it is the heart of what, when you bring up Sherry Edwards, you know, it's like a mutual admiration society. Mm-hmm. I think she's been doing fantastic work. Mm-hmm. You know, she was one of the first ones that actually came out and said, you know, folks, healing can be administered by frequency, by energy,
yes.
Vibrating at certain levels and frequencies. Those vibrations are healing and therapeutic. Well, she took a lot of you know, grief from a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, she has sustained. She's been sustained. I did a radio interview with Sherry, I think, about a week or so ago.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So she's still doing a great, great work out there. And I think that is the solution. See, what we've come up with, you know, there's always got to be a way out of the insanity. You know, God would not have, Creator would not have put us in this position if the Creator didn't really love us.
Yeah.
And the lessons, of course, karma, sometimes they're hard. And the pain that's inflicted sometimes wakes us up. And we need that. Unfortunately, the human mind and human behavioral conditioning has degenerated us to the point where we need to get whacked in a big way. And so that's where I see the world is right now. But I also understand that what we're heralding is the key to the house of David that opens doors that no man can open and closes doors that no man can close. Those are spiritual portals. And in my opinion, based on a massive amount of information and intelligence and science and mathematics and hard, solid evidence, 528 cycles per second,
mm-hmm.
five in frequency of sound, and then also 528 in nanometers of light, is the miraculous key that could turn everything around.
Wow. And this is our all to open our hearts again.
That's right. And that's what we do. All the money that we get, all of the time that we spend, our main mission is to simply continue to output that frequency of love. That's pure tone love. In my opinion, based on the evidence, the theory is still needs to be refuted. Again, if you advance a claim, then our claim is that 528 is the heart of the universe, and that if you sync, if you tune into that clear channel broadcast from the heart of the Creator, because we know it's the heart of sunshine, 528 nanometers of light is the heart of sunshine.
Right.
We know that green grass, chlorophyll, is vibrating optimally at 528. It's giving us that energy in the oxygen we're breathing, because chlorophyll, whether it's the plants, the botanical world, or the algae in the oceans, mm-hmm. that's what's producing the oxygen. And that color, that pigment of greenish yellow light, which in Oriental medicine is your heart chakra,
mm-hmm.
that energy is vibrating the oxygen that sustains us, that we're breathing. That is the pure oxygen of healing. When you have all sorts of illnesses, oxygenation therapies are fantastic. It is the essence of the chemical equation of water, H plus plus OH minus equals H2O. The H plus means acid. It burns. It causes disease. Acid rain is a symptom of the criminal psychopathology of the people like Bill Gates, Rockefellers, Rothschilds, people, energy industrialists, the Enron group. Those people who are doing this are poisoning the planet with acid rain because they're burning up. They're actually causing the chemical equation to lose energy. All disease, chronic diseases are caused by acidification of the body chemistry.
Right.
So whether it's the planet as a whole or ourselves and our individual cells, each of us, if that acidification continues, we're going to get sick and die. And that's what's happening to the planet and each other. So the
hence our chemtrails.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then the electron, I call it the electron of love. That electron that's carried in the oxygen is the symbol for it is that negatively charged entity on that chemical equation, H plus plus OH minus equals water, H2O. Well, the OH minus is the hydroxyl radical that alkalinizes.
Mm.
And in natural medicine, a lot of us have, over the last several years, largely due to the work I did with Jim Karnstadt.
Uh-huh.
Jim Karnstadt was really the first one who came out. He's passed away now, but Jim was the first one that said to the world, hey, everybody, you got to look at alkalization as being foremost important in healing and sustaining. And so we did a audio many years ago that was called Survival Water, pH, and Oxygen,
mm-hmm.
where we introduced this whole concept. And then, so, you know, subsequently, you had many thousands and thousands of naturopathic doctors and healers realize, hey, man, this is what we've got to do. We've got to alkalinize. And that's where my work with Dr. Lee Lorenzen and Patrick Flanagan, Lorenzen and Flanagan were heavy involved in the same graduate school program looking at microhydrin and water and structuring of water. And I learned with Dr. Masaru Emoto. Dr. Emoto is a good friend of mine.
Oh, nice. And he's cool.
Yeah, he's wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
He passed away, too, a couple years ago. But his life's work, he's left us with a fantastic contribution to humanity. And he and I studied under the same Dr. Lee Lorenzen. His water science mentor was my water science mentor, Lorenzen. And so this is the contribution that we made. People don't even realize, you know, that whole pH oxygen thing came out of this camp of people who were dedicated humanitarians and health scientists and have now advanced the thesis that could set humanity free. Because you see that oxygen, OH negative charge radical that alkalinizes is vibrating in love, 528. It's vibrating in that frequency.
So is that similar to, like, you know, when you get a thunderstorm, you have the negative ions that run if you walk on the beach, that kind of stuff?
Yes, exactly. You know how great you feel after that? It felt so good, and it's enlivening, and it's balancing, and it's healing, and de-stressing. And you walk into a forest and you spend a couple hours walking through the forest, you feel similarly. And then, you know, you go instantaneously and jump in the ocean and you get a baptism. Or after a hard day's work, if you don't live near the ocean, you just get into a bathtub or you take a shower, and suddenly now you refresh, you're like a whole new human being. How does that happen? It happens exactly what I'm telling you. You've got electrons of love that are vibrating at the heart of God, a heart of nature. And it instantaneously, energetically zaps you back into where you're supposed to be to begin with.
Mm. And this is why a lot of people now, we all do alkaline water.
That's right.
We have our little machines.
That's
9.5.
Right. That's exactly right. That, now you know the history of how we got there.
Nice. Important role, I think, in people who are on the path in our lives. And I didn't even realize how much of a role you played. So thank you, Dr. Horowitz. I really thank you.
Thank the creator. Believe me, I shouldn't even be here anymore.
Well, you have things to do. Are you familiar with Dr. Sebi, who worked out of Honduras? His work, too?
Yeah, I've heard of him. I haven't met him, and I haven't studied his work, but I've heard of it.
No, because he also passed away, too. Yeah, it's amazing. People pass away. They just kind of half disappear and pass away. Yeah. So now that we have this 528 code, where else can we find this? Do we get this in music? Do we get this? Can we get this off frequency? And I don't remember if... I don't remember with Dr. Emoto if he actually had a, if he did a water crystal with 528. I can't remember.
Yes, he did. He did a beautiful, yeah. As a matter of fact, Dr. Emoto used to contact me for 528 tuning forks. And I supplied Dr. Emoto with one of the most powerful demonstrations that he did all over the world. Because he was Japanese, he spoke Japanese, he didn't speak English, he had a translator with him pretty much in every country.
Uh-huh.
And the translator would stand on stage about 20 yards away from him. The translator, of course, had a microphone, Saro had a microphone, and he would strike his tuning fork into his mic, and the audience would hear it.
Mm-hmm.
And then he would put his hand on his tuning fork, shut it down. People would hear that. They would see him holding the tuning fork so it wasn't playing anymore.
Uh-huh.
And the 20 yards away, the translator's similar 528 tuning fork would play without having been struck.
Yes, yes.
And so that is a demonstration of what he basically said. Well, this shows you that from your heart, my heart, you know, we are resonating and affecting each other at a mm-hmm. distance. And what I did is I basically went into this phenomenon in the book of 528, Prosperity Key of Love. That's really the landmark book that goes into all of this wonderful news about how we're going to get out of this mess with 528 love. You know, basically, this is a fantastic. It's the modern gospel. It's gospel means good news, great news. It's the modern gospel. And so I show you that it's physics. It's basic understanding of how the hydrated atmosphere, because the air is hydrated. It's got little water molecules in it. The entire universe is full of water. NASA science has already proven that. And they've measured the sound of the sun. The sound of the sun incredibly waffles right around 528, you know, an octave of 528. And 528 is very powerful. Of course, it would be. Heart of sunshine. And the theory is that light comes out of sound. And we see that phenomenon in sonoluminescence. Sonoluminescence is what has been demonstrated by dolphins when they hit these high-pitched frequencies that cause bubble rings underwater mm-hmm. to glow. You have light suddenly appearing, just like the sun suddenly is appearing. In essence, in theory, then, you have a very high probability that the Creator is right now recreating everything through sound, including the sunshine. And so the sunshine is, going back to the previous discussion about chemistry of water and chemistry of life that is high and rich in love electrons, is you've got solar radiation, which is 100% hydrogen. The sun is 98% hydrogen, 2% helium. Helium is double hydrogen. And so you have 100% hydrogen of sunshine. that's pouring out solar radiation in electrons. And those are then seen through the water in the sky, you know, when it rains, you see rainbows.
Right.
And that's why at the heart of the rainbow, you have greenish yellow, 528 nanometers of light, your heart chakra, greenish yellow. So that's the, you know, as above, so below, as it is in the macrocosm, it is in the microcosm. Mm-hmm. And that's why we can reasonably theorize all of the things that I'm saying. We know bees buzz, honeybees, that are making this wonderful honey in their honeycombs. They're buzzing at 528 hertz frequency. We've measured it, and people have measured it, and they published it. You know, it's just, it's fantastic. So, yes, the music is available. We are having a lot of trouble with hackers because the cartel doesn't want this revolution to happen. So they have, for the several years, every time we fix it, they zap it again. They cause problems again. 528radio.com. Right now it's dysfunctioning, and we're working on it. We're actually doing a lot of work right now, and it costs a lot of money to do this stuff, and we depend on people's donations to sustain us. You know, people that are buying products from our sponsors, which is Cure Shop, CureShoppe.com. Fantastic products on Cure Shop. Oxy Silver with 528 resonance frequency is fantastic. Liquid Dentist, which starts with 528 frequency. Water, good, great water that is carrying that miraculous healing frequency. These are some of the products on Cure Shop. And then sponsor HealthyWorldStore.com is another way that people can support our work. Well, all of the money that is donated is going into the project that we have for global transformation, which is 528 Radio Network. We launched 528 Revolution Television. It features Conscious Species Network. So it's revolutiontelevision.net. It has a lot of information, videos that we produced in, about the 528. The 528 Key Movie is there. You can get, that's a pay-per-view. It's not a lot of money, but it's your money that you're putting into this sustains the 528 Radio Network. And we launched a dozen stations. Our goal is to have several dozen covering every genre of music. And we produced a free transposition. When the site is operating optimally, and we're, again, it's currently under reconstruction and repair, that the remastering of all of the music that was recorded in A440 standard tuning, which is distressing, it's damaging, it's diseasing, because it's not in sync with Love 528. It's out of harmony with nature. And let me restate that. It gets a little technical because you're dealing with nine core creative frequencies to the perfect circle of sound. That is that the entire universe is constructed based on the intelligence that we have and the evidence is by nine core. Four creative frequencies, of which 528 is, again, the heart.
One of them.
It certainly is one of them. We know it's the third note, the miracle note. In the original musical scale that the Roman Catholic Church had heralded, they were using it early on. The hymn to St. John the Baptist was the most spiritually uplifting hymn of all the ages. It was based on the original solfeggio musical scale, ut, re, mi, fa, sol, la. Today it's do, re, mi, fa, sol, la. Well, the mi, the third note, stands for miragistorum in Latin, miracles in English. So the miracle note of the universe, one of the nine core creative frequencies, is a 528 frequency resonating note. That's pure tone love, in my opinion, based on the evidence. And love is the universal healer and sustainer. So that is what really connects us to each other and to Creator, and that is a frequency that is not in harmony with only one of the nine notes. And that note happens to be 741 frequency. That note happened to have been selected by the Rockefellers and the Rockefeller Foundation in 1938, after a decade of acoustic weaponry, research and development. Now think about this for a second. If you're heavily involved in war making and population destroying, and you now know that the whole field of acoustics is so powerful, that you then find out how to cause targeted populations to be diseased and distressed. Well, that's what they did in the 1930s with RCA and EMI and the Rockefeller Foundation. And they then caused, because they had such a hard time persuading Europeans' finest musicians, all the classical composers, you know, the heart of the music world is in Vienna. And so that they couldn't persuade the Viennese musicians and composers to tune to 741, which is F sharp, which is, they couldn't get them out of the habit of tuning to 528. Hmm. They were using originally, they were using what's called A444.
Hmm.
444 cycles per second is 444 hertz. That's the A note that the original composers in classical music felt. They felt it. It was perfect.
Mm-hmm.
It was where if you would tune to that at the beginning of a concert, what I'm telling you right now is research from Llewellyn Lloyd.
Mm-hmm.
He was the expert in the field of what we're talking about, and he published in the Journal of the British Royal Society publication. He said, if you tune your orchestra at the beginning of the concert at A444, at the end of the concert, everybody is still in A444.
Wow.
He said, but if you tune to what the Rockefellers want to impose on the Western world, A440, at the end of the concert, everybody's out of tune and all over the place.
Chaos.
And that is exactly what they selected. Now, the Rockefellers had trouble because of people like Lloyd not wanting to go there, not wanting to institutionalize A440. So they needed a publicist. They needed a persuasion artist. They needed a big liar. Believe it or not, this is truth. It's unbelievable. But this was 3 months before Hitler invaded Poland. Okay? This was 3 months before that British intelligence and American, before it was CIA, it was OSS. They knew that Hitler was arming to go to war against the world. This was 3 months before Hitler invaded Poland. They had all this intelligence. Rockefeller hired Joseph Goebbels, Nazi propaganda minister for the Third Reich, to go into the British Standards Institute and persuade the Standards Institute to cause A440 to be, quote, concert pitch, standard tuning.
Whoa.
And so that then, when you tune to A440, which is what all the music does right now in the Western world that's been recorded, and that's why we created 528records.com to be a free music transposition website where we, for free, will remaster that music. And we'll send it back. You'll send it up in an MP3, and we send it back to you, transposed in an MP3, and it changes through an algorithm from A440 to A444, which gives you C528. So C, that's like C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. That's the beginning and the end of the scale, the musical scale in contemporary music, Western world music. So the basis of that is 528, love then. And then otherwise, if you're in A440, Rockefeller imposed standard tuning, then your F sharp note, which is dominant in a major chord called the D major chord, then it plays in dissonance to love. It plays in dissonance to healing and sustaining in nature. And it's interesting because from a philosophical perspective, I note as a scientist, I note that there's only one frequency in the original 9 core creative frequencies. I mentioned it's 741. That doesn't get along with love, doesn't get along with pretty much the heart of nature. And that is a natural frequency. The creator created it. The creator uses it. In other words, there is a need for positive, negative, yin yang.
Right.
For peace versus conflict. You know, it's interesting. It's a fascinating discussion. But excuse me. But that is what we've got going on with the fact that now, today, the music is in 741 basically scale. A440 creates A440 creates F sharp 741, and that's dominant in pretty much the Western world's music today. And that the issue is that it caused 8% of the population that heard it to become aggressive and actually riot. These people became so emotionally stimulated that they became riotous, and that's where you had the transition from swooning with people, like Dean Martin, to suddenly now in Elvis's day and rock star, the king of rock, Elvis Presley, his concert in Vancouver was the first concert where the audience rioted. And if you go back, I wrote this up in the book of 528, Prosperity Key of Love, the book, you'll see that he was handled. Elvis Presley was being directed by a military intelligence agent called the Colonel. And the Colonel was feeding him drugs. They were controlling Elvis Presley. And it was an experiment that they were literally unfolding, because at the time this was before the British invasion. And the British invasion was completely controlled. And ultimately, the rock and roll era, where you had this aggression suddenly take over from the peace and harmony that classical music world knew and still produces, to this chaos, to this kind of music that, unfortunately, today it's even gotten much, much worse.
It's worse, yeah.
Yeah, and that's the sad thing, because, for example, even if you take rap music and you realize it is an opportunity to deliver great messages and reinforcing positive things, it tends to be instead extremely aggressive and
insightful.
Yeah, it's just a challenge. And so looking at it from that perspective, I see it as a genocidal weapon. You know, you're, again, dividing races, you're dividing religions, you're dividing sexes, you're dividing economics, everybody, rich, poor, and politically creating divisions. Well, the rap world is a world in which it's controlled Universal Music Group, NBC Universal Group, we've exposed heavily. If you look at our video up on revolutiontelevision.net, the video is called the Paris Attacks video, and it's fantastic. It exposes the hideous reality of what's really taking place politically in the music world and in the Bataclan Theater massacre, what happened, what really happened there. And then you begin to see that NBC Universal, that controls largely our musical world, is a virtual operation of the Illuminati. And it's sick. It's really, really sick of what's happening.
Wow. So now we've come to the end of this first hour. So let people know, how can they get more information about you and which website should they check out? We know you have to check out 528radio.com, and that should be up and running soon. And what other websites would you like us to check out for you?
Well, there's two, the good news and the bad news. The good news is on... Yeah, the great news website, if you study the website information, you'll be very blessed. It's 528revolution.com, 528revolution.com. And then the bad news is on waronwethepeople.com. So, okay. Yeah, waronwethepeople.com. And the bad guys don't like that website because it exposes... You know, exposes them heavily.
It and doesn't then, show up when I search you.
Yeah, right. So you notice that. Notice they suppress us. I mean, Google, YouTube heavily suppresses everything that we've been doing. You know, they've been doing, we actually have a database, a whole file on how they, Google, YouTube, have been suppressing our numbers. I mean, you look at our numbers and you can't see, you know, he's got a couple thousand people. You know, my video, Dr. Robert Gallo, it's, there's a video up called The Man Who Created AIDS.
Mm-hmm.
And a few other people have published it, and so it still gets up there despite the fact that they censored and pulled down mine. I had about, I think I had about 2 million hits on mine, views on mine before they pulled it. There's another one up right now, I think, that has over 3 million. And... the fact is, you don't see the numbers. I used to be actually, I have data that tracks my popularity on the web before Dr. Oz was promoted by Oprah. And I can see, and I kept the data because I saw this kind of manipulation happening. And I started to collect the data just for a lawsuit against Google. And I saw how my numbers were increasingly dropping. I started this to get this data back in 2008 already.
Mm-hmm.
And when I saw that Wikipedia was defaming me, so I started to collect data for lawsuits. And then... Sherry Kane joined me in 2009, and we had in 2009, 2010, Sherry and I did probably a half a dozen articles together. But I had already published several hundred articles, you know, and when you did a search in 2008 on the internet for Dr. Leonard Horowitz or Len Horowitz, you would have about 3 million hits.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sherry joined me in 2009, and by 2010, if you did a search on Dr. Len Horowitz, it dropped down to like 470,000. Yeah. Dropped down to 470. But then you did Sherry Kane, and she had 3 million. Right? Yeah. We have hard data that shows how they manipulated me. And how they, you know, my numbers, popularity or perceived popularity on the internet.
Uh-huh.
And then it's outrageous. It's ridiculous. But that's what they do.
Oh, so waronwethepeople.com, and just go to it. You have to type it all the way in and then do 528revolution.com. And then we also have 528radio.com. So there are three websites that you can check out that you'll get all this incredible information. And we'd like to thank you so much for being on with us this first hour. And I can't wait to hear what you have to say in the woo-woo hour, second hour.
Thank you. You know, so, there's one more website is revolutiontelevision.net.
Okay.
Revolutiontelevision.net has all of our videos restored.
Oh, nice. 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 Okay. So thank you, Dr. Leonard Horowitz, for being on with us today. And, you know, keep doing what you do, because it's important to the rest of us out here. We need you to continue the research and share with us all that's happening and opening eyes of new people that haven't had a chance to know your work. And now they're asking questions. People are looking. They want to know what's going on. And thank you for providing that.
Well, thank you, Charlene. Thank you for having me on, and I look forward to speaking with you in the second hour.
Great. Thank you. Take care. You've been listening to Boundless Spirit Radio and our incredible guest, Dr. Leonard Horowitz.
Boundless Spirit goes off the rails. Next up in our members-only segment, the Woo Woo Hour. Whether it's happening on the planet, off the planet, or inside the planet, host Charlene Springer, expert guests, and you dare to go there in the Woo Woo Hour.